Senator Grassley asks counsel for the President. Does the House's failure to enforce its subpoenas render its, quote, obstruction of Congress, end quote, theory unprecedented?
Mr. Chief Justice, Senators, the answer is yes. As far as I am aware, there has never been a prior instance in which there's been an attempt, even in the House, as in the Nixon proceeding, never mind in the Clinton proceeding, which actually left the House and came to the Senate, to suggest that there can be obstruction of Congress when there hasn't been anything beyond simply issuing a subpoena, getting resistance, and then throwing up your hands and giving up and saying, oh, well, that's obstruction. In the Clinton situation, most of the litigation was with the independent counsel, and there were privileges asserted and litigation again and again. But the point is that the issues about the privileges were all litigated, and they were resolved before things came to this body. Similarly, in the Nixon impeachment proceeding within the House, a lot of investigation had been done by the special counsel, and there was litigation over assertions of privileges there in order to get at the tapes, and some tapes or transcripts had already been turned over. But again, there was litigation about the assertion of the privilege in response to the grand jury subpoena that then fed into the House's proceedings. So it would be completely unprecedented for the House to attempt to actually bring a charge of obstruction into the Senate, where all they can present is, well, we issued a subpoena and there were legal grounds asserted for the invalidity of the subpoena, and there were different grounds, as I've gone through. I won't repeat them all in detail here, but some were because the subpoenas were just invalid when issued because there was no vote. Some is that the subpoenas for witnesses were invalid because senior advisors to the President had absolute immunity from compulsion. Some were that they were forcing executive branch officials to testify without the benefit of agency counsel and executive branch counsel with them. So the various reasons asserted for the invalidity and the defects in various subpoenas, and then no attempt to enforce them, no attempt to litigate out what the validity or invalidity might be, but just bring it here as an obstruction charge is unprecedented. And I'll note the House managers have said, and I'm sure that they will say again today, that, well, but if we had gone to court, the Trump administration would have said that the courts don't have jurisdiction over those claims. Now, that is true. In some cases, there's one being litigated right now related to the former counsel to the President, Don McGahn. The Trump administration position, just like the position of the Obama administration, is that an effort by the House to enforce a subpoena in Article III court is a non-justiciable controversy. That is our position, and we would argue that in court. But that's part of what would have to be litigated. That doesn't change the fact that the House managers can't have it both ways. And I want to make this clear. The House managers want to say that they have an avenue for going to court. They're using that avenue for going to court. They actually told the court in McGahn that once they reached an impasse with the executive branch, the courts were the only way to resolve the impasse. And as I explained the other day, there are mechanisms for dealing with these disputes between the executive and Congress. The first is an accommodations process. They didn't do that. We offered to do that in the White House counsel's October 8th letter. They didn't do accommodations. If they think they can sue, they have to take that step, because the Constitution, the courts have made clear, require incrementalism in disputes between the executive and the legislative branch. So if they think that the courts can resolve that dispute, that's the next step. They should do that and have that litigated. And then things can proceed on to a higher level of confrontation. But to jump straight to impeachment, to the ultimate constitutional confrontation, doesn't make sense. It's not the system that the Constitution requires, and it is unprecedented in this case. Thank you.
Thank you, counsel.